Hi guys, my name is Bianca. Welcome to my channel if you're new. Welcome back if you are returning. This is going to be a quick update video, a little mini haul video, because I've gotten some new supplies and I am really eager to jump in and start testing them out. So I hope everyone is doing okay. I just want to start out with that. Thank you for spending a little bit of time with me, and let's jump right into it. So I've spoken about the Prismacolors that I wanted to get. I had a very old set. I still have a very, very, very old set, limited set that when I was going through college, Prismacolor was what we were using. And I think Staedtler and what's the other one? I know there's another brand that we used in class. But Prismacolors, of course, were popular even in the age of the dinosaurs. So I only had a few. Like if I have like 30 colors in my Prismacolor set, and because I bought them individually, I didn't buy them like in a set like this. They do have them in sets, but I remember at my local art supply store, they had them all along the wall, and you could just pick them out and buy them loose. And so I would buy them depending on the project that I was doing for class. And so that's how I have a few Prismacolors to my name. But that was like, oof, in another lifetime, that's how long ago it was. So I really wanted to get a core set. And I didn't want to just get the 12 or the 24 or anything like that. This is quite a bit of a splurge. Not everybody, especially in these days, could afford something like this. So by no means, I don't want you to think that you have to have Prismacolors in order to do any kind of coloring at all. Not at all. As much as I love Prismacolors, you're going to see that most of my completed pages have been done with the K-Lore sets. And I actually do love the K-Lore sets a lot. So here is the Prismacolor set, the 150. This is how it comes. I have opened them, but I have not yet used them. They come in these little trays, just like the K-Lores do. There's nothing particularly special about this type of packaging, and I think there are 6 trays in here all together. Yeah, 3 in each side, and for 150 pencils, including, well, maybe it's 149, and including this colorless one to help blend. We'll be trying that out, I guess. So I haven't counted them. I don't know if it's 150 plus the one, or if it's 149 plus this one. So, but anyway, it doesn't matter. This is what I really wanted. I wanted to have a variety of colors. And again, this is not something that you need to have in your arsenal, but it is what most of the ladies that I am watching have, and it's their reference. And if I need to do a color comparison, then I have with which to make a reference. It doesn't necessarily mean that while I do my following along other folks' colorings, that I will be using the Prismacolors. You know, I'm actually quite happy with my with my K-Lores. They're not, I'm really impressed with them. Anyway, but I do have my Prismacolor sets now, and I think I might actually test them out up against the old Prismacolors that I had to see if there's been any changes in the formula and in the color shades. But, you know, I don't think anybody's particularly interested in that. Let me move you guys a little bit to a safer area. Hopefully I'm not going to knock you down so much. There we go. Hopefully that'll be safe. Oops. Maybe some movement there. Hold on. Let me reposition you guys so you can get a better view. Alright. Hopefully that's safe and I don't knock you guys all over the place. Alright, here we go. So, that's that one. I also got, because I'm a pencil junkie, I got these that I was really, I'm curious about this brand. This is another well-known brand. If you're a student in the arts, this, you can find this on the shelves just as easily as you do the smaller Prismacolor sets. But this is the Castle Arts, and I got the 72. I have the bigger tin on my wish list, as well as the watercolors, but this particular one happened to be on sale and I just couldn't pass that up. Usually I would save my pennies and buy the big set so I can have as many as I want to, or you know, as many so I can have access to more colors when I do these types of purchases. But this one was on sale and I couldn't pass it up, and it came in a little case, which now I'm not sure if I like this type of case. I looked at it a little bit. It does come with a little booklet that gives you the basics for perspective if you want to start drawing. It gives you shading, texture, all of these things, and even the color wheel, which I think that's really nice. Guys, if you're starting like me, one of the things that I remember from my time in college in my art class was that this was very important. We spent a lot of time coloring the color wheel. I think it is more important than swatching out the colors for each individual pencil, is to truly understand how the color wheel works so that you have color theory as an arsenal, you know, as a tool for your decision making when you are coloring your pages. That's more useful, I think, than pencils and what brands of pencils and how soft or hard they are. If you have to color a page with Crayola, and I've done it with Crayola crayons, as long as your color theory is sound, you're gonna make an amazing image, you know, you're gonna delight the eye. And yes, I'll speak for myself. I'm doing this for stress relief. You know, I don't want to get too highfalutin with all of this, but also I want to enjoy the final result of something that I've done. You know, that I think that is also as much fun as putting pigment to paper. You understand what I'm saying? So these are very inexpensive. Sometimes they sell these to a pack on Amazon, and it's good to have on hand because it shows you what happens when you mix the colors and the results you'll get. Like if you have yellow green, or if you have green, if you have blue green as your starting pigment, whether it's a pencil, whether it's watercolor, wash, acrylic oils, whatever, your starting pigment, the pigment color that you'll add, and the result that you would get on this side of the page, plus you have your grayscale values. Okay, now there are cool grays and there are warm grays, so that's another thing that you need to kind of be aware of. That it's like the undertones of your colors. And in the back of the color wheel, you have how to pick the color scheme for you. If you want to do a complementary color, or if you want to do a split complementary, a triad, a tetrad. There's two different types of tetrads, warm tetrads and cool tetrads, okay? So, or light and dark, something like that. And a tetrad is four colors arranged into two complementary pairs. So as you turn the wheel, it gives you a hint, you know, it gives you a guide as to what would be your best colors to choose for a scheme for a particular one. If it's not intuitive and you're finding yourself kind of stuck and not sure what to match what with what, something like this can help you to start along. All right. Color theory doesn't really change. So it's it's, you know, we as human beings have a particular taste, I guess is what we would call it. And our eyes gravitate to certain colors a certain way, you know, besides having our own favorite colors. Things make sense visually and in our heads when we follow along with the theory. And we enjoy it much more because it's just kind of the way it is. It's kind of like breathing, you know. We don't really think about breathing. We know breathing is good for us. We do it. You know what I mean? It's an organic thing. Color is kind of the same way. It's just like an organic thing. And knowing the theory does not make it any less enjoyable. On the contrary, it especially if you like to play around with coloring and painting and drawing and things like that, this is really nice that they included this in the books, in this little book here. And then it puts the, you know, it teaches you about the pressures and all of this other stuff. So it's really nice. Oh, and it's got a little page. Ooh. You can use Vaseline. Learn something new right now. Olive, coconut oil, or light seed oils are great for a smooth flow blend. I'm sure it is, but I would have to test to see how it would respond on the type of pages that we're coloring in. Baby oil breaks down the pigment so it's brushable and easy to rub. I'll have to look these up on Amazon. Learn something new now. I've just been coloring straight and blending with the little blenders. Ooh, new thing to experiment with. Okay, cool enough. You see, so this is definitely worth it. And it came in this little pack right here. All right, and we do have the sheet to color these things out. I've been doing those as I go along with my other sets. And then it also has this. I think this is just a promo. Yeah, this is for the promo, the other types of products that they have. Ooh. Wow. And their color range and what product it comes in. The little squares and the dots and so forth talks about whether that particular color that we see here is available in a pencil or a watercolor, gouache, or anything else that they have. Huh, that's interesting. That's really interesting. I'll have to take a look at their product range. If anybody knows if they've actually experimented with this brand, Castle, I know it's a well-known brand. I mean, I see it all the time. I've even seen it in Walmart. You know, it's somewhat, maybe it's mid-tier as far as the price range goes. I'm not sure. I just buy what I like. I don't really know, but I don't think it's too inexpensive. Yeah, I think this might be a mid-tier brand. If you guys know, correct me. It's fine. Ooh, if you hear rain, well, it's raining. It started raining. All right, so that came with that, and this is how they came packaged. These particular sleeves. I've seen some of these that are kind of like this. That this actually comes out, but for with this pack, it does not. But I like the way they arranged it, pretty much the same way I would. Pinks, purple, so they're arranged really nicely. And they seem to be kind of, they feel good. You know, they're not too thin, they're not too thick a pencil. The cores are kind of substantial, so I'm eager to try these as well. So hopefully in the next videos, we'll start doing like little mini color alongs just to test out the new pencils that I've gotten. All right, so I got these. Also, I picked up this And the little Arrtx's, I think I mentioned it. I'm not sure if I've shown it, but if I did, here they are again. I don't remember what I do from one video to the next, so I apologize for that. But I think I did mention that I wanted to get this set because it's both neon and metallic. And these come in a very strange shape. I'm very unfamiliar with this brand, except that I've heard some folks talk about it. This particular set is geared towards children, of course, because these are really, really bright colors. And this is a triangular shaped pencil. None of the colors, whether they be metallic or neon, have names or numbers. So that's usually not a good thing. But then again, this is geared towards kids. We'll see how they actually work. The reviews were amazing, so I'm hoping they'll work regardless. I don't really like being a pencil snob or anything like that, or I'm not about that, but hopefully. And they were inexpensive, so you know, that all of that having been said, you do get what you pay for. Sometimes you do get lucky, like I got lucky with my Kalor pencils a lot. And this is a metallic gouache. I've been trying to find something that would make me happy when I do accents and backgrounds in some of the pages. And I'm gonna try it, but then again, I'm not a fan of too many liquidy things, but this is like really, really pasty. So we'll see if this will actually hit the mark for me when it comes to coloring books. So let me see here. How do we take these out? So these come like this. Oh, you can see how metallic they are. Anyway, I got this set in Amazon. I don't want to make a mess with them right now because this is an incredibly new thing to me. The thing about this set is that it is meant to keep, once you open up each individual pod, it's meant to keep it so that it doesn't dry out. And that I found really intriguing. And they have several different types of these, like regular. I think they have pastels, but I wanted the metallics because I'm a shimmery girl. Okay. So another set of pencils that I had said that I don't know if I talked about this one, but I did order the Arrtx pencils again due to curiosity. So these came highly recommended by a few of you who are my brand new subscribers, and I purchased the 126 colors. They have two options, I believe, is what I saw. One that's 72, and then this larger one. And this is how it comes. I haven't tested these out either, but I definitely want to. I just saw one of the ladies that I'm subscribed to make a comparison between these and the Prismacolors, and they're not entirely tit for tat, and I think she had the 72. I'm not sure which set she had, whether if it was this one or the smaller set, but not all of them are tit for tat with the Prismacolors. But honestly, I also don't care. I don't need to have a tit for tat. And I like having different quality pencils in my arsenal. I think I've mentioned this before. I like them from stiff to all the way creamy if I possibly can. The one type of pencil that I have not experimented with is the oil pencils. And I have to do a little bit more research when it comes to that because I'm not sure. I mean, I do know there's these wax types and there's the oil types, but I've never colored or painted or drawn with oil pencils that I can't remember ever using an oil-based pencil. So I know they're out there. I think Faber-Castell has a really nice set. I've seen they pop up on my recommendeds on Amazon all the time, but I'm shying away from them because I don't really know much about them. So I will have to hunt down to see who uses oil pencils and what is the difference between oils and wax. But this is such a pretty, pretty pencil. I like the way, let me see if I can get one that's color where you can show. So the way these are is like they have this little barcode here, and then they have the name in the back with the number, a serial number, I guess it's for the color. And then they have the logo here in the front. I don't even know if you can actually see any of that. This is so small. But anyway, they are incredibly pretty. They're really, really pretty. I'm eager to try them. So we shall see. However, the packaging is I don't know how to feel about this packaging, because okay, so you can put it together and then when you close it, but you kind of have to hold it because you see it becomes unraveled. So these two sides here are not there's nothing that hold them together, and the whole thing just becomes unraveled. It's pretty, it's creative, but it's also spectacularly annoying. So I don't know that I'm gonna keep them in their box. Okay, so we are going to be testing those pencils in some brand new books that I've hauled. So I've got a few by Johanna Basford. I got quite a collection from her right now. I got the little miniature ones. I have the two big ones that these are from. Oh, I really want to do this tree in the big one, but I think I might actually do it in this one. Oh, anyway, so I got the two little miniature ones. I have This Is How to Draw Inky Wonderlands, which she teaches you how to do the drawings that she does, to draw kind of like the way she does it. And I'm so excited to give it a try. I like drawing as much as I like coloring, so I have a few sketchbooks that I think I'm going to practice these. This is a great book. I think I'm gonna have a lot of fun practicing these. Absolutely. I love her style. It's very comforting. It's a very comforting way of drawing. It's childlike but grown up, if that makes any sense. I think the reason why she's so popular is because this kind of, there's something visceral about her style, the same way with Hannah Carlson. There is something very visceral about the way these two ladies draw, that it's intuitive and organic whilst being, you know, just fun to color. There's something very, very special about it, and I think that's why the images kind of stay with you. The line work stays with you. So anyway, I made a mess. Okay, so so I got the miniatures. Hopefully I'll pick up a style or two, and then I picked up this one, which is actually something to read. It's a book you can color, but there's a story in it, and this one's called Ivy and the Inky Butterfly, A Magical Tale to Color. So as you color the pages, you can read the stories. I thought that was really interesting. It's a really thick book, and the pages are thicker, I think, than her regular coloring books, if I'm not mistaken. I'll have to try that, but it's a really substantial book to hold. This one I picked up, these are Amazon purchased, all of these, except for this one. I think I purchased this one at Walmart, and it's coloring, it's a road trip where you go through the USA in different states. The Grand Canyon, different places where we know of, you can go. So it's like that. It's you went in, what you would probably see if you went on a road trip in an RV, I think. So here are the ones by Hannah Carlson. So I picked up this one, Grains of Gold, which I think is a compilation because it only has 11 new drawings plus 83 favorites, and I think I recognize some of these. So this is something of a compilation, like this image I think is in another book, I just don't know which one. Oh, and by the way, she does have her own Facebook page, which you can follow. I just found out today. So I signed up to follow her on Facebook, and I'm not a really big Facebook person, but she's going to be coming out with a new book in September called Atlantis, and I can't wait. I definitely want to get it. The next one that I got is The Summer Nights. And I have another one on my wish list. I think I've already selected the image that I want to paint. that I want to color in. And it's this one where it looks like, I think these are storks. But I think I want to color them as like hybrid flamingos and peacocks. But I think these might actually be storks. I'm not sure. They're storks or they're peacocks. I'm not sure. But there's usually not, this doesn't look like a peacock feather to me, which is why I'm leaning more towards storks. But I can see these being in a blue, pinkish type of color scheme. I think I'm going to take a little bit of creative license with these. But this is what I would like to do first in this book, is this double page. And then I also got the Mythographic Dream Weaver. I have a few other mythographics coming in, but they're for other paychecks. This one is by Alessandra Fusi. And I think I selected the Space Kitty. Don't know when I'm going to be able to get to these, but definitely those are the ones that I want to do. All right. So, I guess I will show you what I have been working on and what I have completed thus far. Alrighty, so current whips. I think I may have only one whip. You guys, I think I have only one whip to show right now, which is this one here by Selena. This is that four books in one compilation, and I am currently working on this image. On the Autumn Spell, this is as far as I've gotten with it, because I tend to jump around from book to book. That's the current, that I think that is the only whip that I have thus far. And these are, I believe, all of my completed pages thus far into the month of May. This is by Gudrun Hall, I think is how you pronounce it. Scenes from the Forest. It's almost a grayscale kind of book, which is really not to my liking, but has a lot of nice portraits in it. It's not too bad. It's not too grayscale heavy. I can still kind of shade my own way. And this is the completed page that I did in this one. These are done with a combination of the Black Widow skin set and Kalor. So I used the skin set, the Black Widow to do her skin, and then the rest is in Kalor and a little bit of a black marker, because this type of line work, when you color it in, kind of gets lost. It's not deep enough. And I kind of like to see the line work in my colorings. I really do. As you can see here, I tried to do the line work in the pink, but it's not as bold as an actual nice dark line work that will survive or come through in the coloring. So, I mean, that is personal preference. It doesn't really matter. But I didn't go back in to do any darker on the flowers themselves, because I don't want too much attention being taken away from her. I thought, you know, this is my first attempt at doing dark skin tone, and I think I can do better than this. I'm going to keep practicing to try to get the shading and the highlights better. But I also wanted to give the Black Widow pencils, the dark skin set, a try. And I made a few mistakes because of the way those pencils, the material in the pencils are. It's better to try to, let me see if I can get them to explain. So usually when I do skin tones, I will go from light to dark, like an under type of underpainting. But just because of the way these pigments are, I don't recommend that you do that. So I think I shaded everything with this lighter one, and then I began to darken in with the chocolate, or the chalk tone, and with the midnight. And then I think the other one that I used was for her, I think it was cinnamon, if I'm not mistaken. So she's mostly cinnamon on top of this leather one. Was it the leather that I used? No, it was not. It was the olive brown. I apologize. So I wanted to try and create an undertone. So this was the one that I used, the olive brown, such a pretty color. But what I found out that it's more trouble than it's worth. So I should have just started and ended everything in cinnamon. It's because of the way of the formula of the pigments of these pencils. They don't, I don't know, I have to keep trying them, but they don't seem for me, and the way that I move across the surface of the page itself, it gave me more trouble than I cared to have. So I'll try again, and I do like them. I do like their pigmentation and everything. It's just that every brand, and I think this might be like a specialty brand, if I'm, you know, like, this isn't something that comes, for some reason I get the impression that this is not something that is from a factory, you know what I mean? Like Kalor and Brunt, that other ones. Like, most of these pencils that you get on Amazon are probably produced in the same factory. I'm not sure that these are. These really do feel different when you are coloring across the page. And there's nothing wrong with that, but they just react different for me. In the way that I'm used to putting my pressure and the way I go along with it, these have a learning curve, and I'm in the midst of doing that with these. So that's my first completed page to show for this. And let's see here, I finally finished a double page. I don't know if I've shown it yet, but here is. Here it is. This is the double page, guys, which I never thought I would finish it. So this is Kalor pencils, some watercolor pencils, I'm not sure if they were Kalor watercolor, which I do have a set of Kalor watercolor pencils. They're really cute, really nice. And some of the gels for here. So it's a bit of mixed media. I don't have any inks, but these are gels to do the sky with. And to do the all of this. And the gels that I used for this, which ones were, oh, okay. So these were the ones, the Sargent pencils, anything that was, because it doesn't, I like these a lot. They, you don't have to have a whole lot of water. You don't have to saturate the page in order to move these pigments around onto this type of smooth page. And I appreciate that. I'm gonna have to get over my bother when it comes to crinkling the pages. If I want to have this type of effect, I'm just gonna have to live with the fact that the pages are gonna warp ever so slightly because this is not watercolor page. Oh, and a new thing that I did get is, okay, wait a minute. I'm all over the place. So I used the Sargent watercolor crayons and I used the King Art gel crayons. Okay, these are water mixed media gel sticks and they're really, really nice. So like the gelatos, an inexpensive version of the Faber-Castell gelatos. That's what's on these pages. That's kind of what they look like. I have this set and a metallic set and I'm not unhappy with the pigmentation and the way they move across the page. It's just really, really nice. And in case you haven't seen these before, oops, they've already become a mess. These are the Sargent watercolor crayons, water soluble, and very, very nice for backgrounds. Very easy. Also, you don't need a whole lot of water. You don't have to saturate the page in order to get the pigment to move around. And that's how I did these clouds with a combination of these two products here. Now, part of the I got these. I forgot to show these. So I have the gels. These are them. I haven't tried them yet, so I can't speak to them, but I think these are the ones that started the whole gel crayon, water soluble crayon craze. It's this particular brand. Correct me if I'm wrong. And these are the gelatos, but these are iridescents. I don't have like the regular ones. I wanted to get colors that I don't want to have doubles in everything except for maybe the color pencils. Yeah, I don't want to have doubles in everything. So this is a regular color set, like the primaries and stuff like that, just regular mattes, although they are quite colorful and they have something of a sheen to them, a brightness to them, if you will. But these are iridescents and I'm eager to try these. And the set that I have in the King Arts are metallics, which I think is a little different than iridescent in itself. We'll put that theory to the test when I start playing with these in full force. But I do have a set of the Faber-Castell gelatos. These were not that expensive, by the way. So, or at least maybe I got it on sale. I don't even remember. I got too much stuff already. All right, so the little alien critters are completed and I'm happy about that. All right, let's see what else. Yeah, completed May 2023, and this is that one, which we'll see. I'm still going to keep the tab, like I said in a previous video, because those that I think I might revisit to do backgrounds on, I'm gonna keep the tabs on. But so this one's completed. The Mythographic Cosmic Spirit. Okay, so I was having a lot of trouble with this one. I totally went off the rails with it, but here she is, fully completed, And I took the advice of one of my subscribers that said make it all night instead of like half night and half day, which is what it was originally. You can go back to other the previous videos and see that I had like this orange going on here because it was supposed to kind of be sunset, but I think I did it all wrong. And anyway, I just went ahead and fully committed to it being like dark, nighttime, whatever. And I gave her from dark, and I had to work with what the pencil work that was already there, which was in the orange. I'm actually not mad about the different tones going on, more pinky purples, more orangey purples, more bluish purples. It's a bit of a mess, but it kind of works. Compared to what was there before, I was finally able to sit down after I did the background and fixed it this way. I was able to sit down and complete the rest and actually have a finished work. So she's done. And now maybe I can move on to other images in the book itself. Because if I have a page that I haven't completed, I experienced that with a Kirby book. It's really difficult for me to sort of move on to another image in the book if the one that I'm currently working on hasn't been completed. I don't know what that's about. I really don't know what that is about, but that seems to be the case for me. And it shouldn't be that way. I should just be able to do whatever I want, whenever I want. But, you know, hey, theories notwithstanding. Okay, so here is the other book that I have by Selena. And I'm just not even going to try to pronounce her last name because I really think that I get it wrong. And this was the mermaid that I was working in this one. And I think that's good. This is going to be my final mermaid for the month of mermaid. I did a couple of, this is done with Kalor pencils, of course, and some gel pens for a little bit of highlights. I find that the jelly metallics don't disturb this paper a whole lot. It doesn't warp it, so that's okay. It's almost like a really sheen metallic finish to it without warping the page too much. I don't know if you can see it very well, but I put it on the some of the scales, on the little sea dragon, on the frame, and in the jewelry that she's wearing, and some through her hair as well. So I'm not mad at it, but I think it could have been better. But anyway, that's what happens when you start coloring, and you just, with every image, I'm hoping to be better with my color stories. We'll see. We're trying. And the very last completed page that I've done is from this one, from Gnome Sweet Gnome by Creative Heaven. The illustrator is Teresa Goodrich, and I completed this page. Sweet dreams. I don't have much to say about it. I'm actually quite happy with the way it turned out. I wish I had done something better with the actual wall in the room. Maybe giving it more texture or some bricks. But I didn't. I'll think about it next time I do a page something like this. I think it would have given it a little bit more character. But it is kind of a busy page to begin with anyway. So I do like the fact that, you know, I kept it within the blue and the yellow more or less. That's kind of like the little thing that he's sleeping with and his little teddy bear. It's cute. I'm actually quite happy with this one. You know, I just have to calm down and just enjoy what I finish. It's not gonna end up in a museum. And you know, just be glad that I finished it. and enjoy it for what it is. That's the whole point of coloring, and let us not all forget that. And I'm really talking to myself on that because that can be something of a perfectionist and unjustifiably too hard on myself. I don't know if you're the same way too, but the whole point again is to color and reduce our stress and anxiety, not to create stress and anxiety for ourselves by trying to create a perfect page in a coloring book. Now, our inner competitors just seem to come out all the time. Anyway, at least it does for me. I'm my own worst enemy when it comes to that. Anyway, so I have to decide what I'm going to color and with which pencil set I'm going to be doing it with. And that'll be the next video that you guys will be seeing. So if you've made it this far into my video, thank you so much for being here. At least you know what's out on the market as far as options to get. You can look all over YouTube and see comparisons between those pencil sets and Prismacolors, which seems to be the base comparisons that everybody makes. But anyway, I will see you guys in the next video. And until then, stay safe and stay colorful. Bye.